Yes, good morning. Thank you very much, Siegfried. This has been a very kind and overly generous introduction of me, whose only function is to introduce others and then, of course, to chair and moderate the discussion. But this is a very honorable position, in fact, because I'm now in the honor of introducing Professor Gao Ximing from the China Academy of Art in Hangzhou. Professor Gao is probably one of the most prolific curators and organizers in contemporary Chinese art practices. He's also the vice president of the China Academy of Art in Hangzhou, one of the two most influential and renowned art schools in China. In this function, he is in fact the youngest representative of a major academy in China. Yeah, so he's, let's say, what we call in German, ein Blitzstarter. Yeah. At the CAA, he's furthermore the head of the School of Intermediate Art, ZIMA, which allows him to invite a great number of international guest professors, including the Rux Media Collective and others. He there runs a curatorial program with the support of many Chinese and international colleagues, including also Johnson Chang, whom we are also going to hear again later. Gao Ximing has been the curator and co-curator of various Shanghai biennials, so he's basically one of the key figures behind the Shanghai Biennial. He's also been the curator of the Guangzhou Biennial and of an innumerable amount of curatorial projects on Chinese art history, with specific interest, if I may say so, in Chinese avant-gardist traditions like the 85 movement and, of course, their political implications. I had actually hoped to meet Gao Ximing already yesterday, but he took the opportunity of having a few hours off from Karlsruhe to immediately go to Strasbourg to have another meeting and to organize another exhibition. So we are very, very lucky to actually get a little bit of hold of him, because he's impossible to grasp, and we should use this opportunity also in the discussion. So thank you very much for coming, Gao Ximing, and thank you all for welcoming him with me. Gao Ximing, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Johan. Thanks so much for the invitation, Professor Zelinsky. And it's my great honor to be here to share my thinking, maybe some dangerous thinking, on the potential spaces of art and art education. For me, this is the same thing. Last 2 weeks, French artist Daniel Brun was shot in a documentary film in Hangzhou. This is a gift of his 80 years birthday given by himself. 12 years ago, during his first visiting to Hangzhou, he saw a great scene like that. Okay, sorry. The full screen, yeah. Yeah, it's a PDF. Yeah.
Wait. Ah, it's...
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Johan. This is 2 o'clock in the morning. It's a scene of registration for the entrance exam of CAA, my school. 2 hours ago, there are 35,000 examinee applied to the academy, and this year more, 65,000. That means we should choose 1,400 most lucky fellows from these 65,000 of candidates. Yeah, this is a picture from this year. So the percentage is less than 3%. I show this picture is not for the enrollment advertisement. I just want to show there is a large scale of the artistic multitude in China. In this situation, art and art education is a very different story from the Europe. Art and education in China should look for its own significance and dimensions. It's a singular sociality and sociability from the real life world of Chinese contemporary. Yeah, this is a museum of academy. This is what I want to show before my presentation. Now we come to my topic today. Over the past 40 years, the development of information economy plus financial capitalism coincide with the rise of global social inequality, polarization and social exclusion. Financial information capitalism has created what Manuel Castells refers to as the fourth world. What is no longer a part of the third world and is not divided by the south and the north, the east and the west. As a result of the global connection and realignment made possible by the network of wealth, information and right, the geopolitical map of the world has been rearranged. Since the beginning of the 21st century, the global network of wealth, information, right has constituted a totality of global governance, transforming and obliterating the traditional form of government and oppression. Precisely, the network of wealth, information, right becomes imperceptible, and the machinery of governance and oppression between inconspicuous. The canals of our struggles are no longer external to us, and we are not even fighting against the bondage of some boundaries. Rather, we simply cannot identify a clear culprit. The boundaries divided companies such as Facebook, Google, Alibaba, and society are no longer clear, as they are merging indefinitely with society and successfully posing under the guise of society itself. So the system of global governmentality that they have constructed eradicates any form of externality. Oppression and exploitation become hidden amongst us. And as they become parts of daily life, that we are situated with enjoyment, we find out that we are in fact demanded to struggle against the mechanism of our own sense and desires. From software to hardware, from coding to governing, capitalism dictates the daily life of people across different regions and if literate through social fabrics and by politics, shaping the form of our behaviors, habits, and dreams. In the past 30 years, capitalism has already evolved to transform from exploitation of our labor value to the dispossession of our sensibilities and mobilities, mobilities in the sense of by politics. The new governmentality of global capitalism is no longer operating through the logic of oppression and exploitation. What remains effective is the logic of substitution in the politics of the consumerism. You want a revolution, here's a social movement. You want a socialist, here's a new left. You want freedom, you get the freedom of open market and the freedom of V media. You want singularity, but change into particularity. You want the people's assembly, but get Facebook friends. You want to be a cultural producer, but you become a consumer. If you want to be a fighter, you will become an actor. the social intermediary mechanism has been renewed, as well as the mode of social governing and the social movements. The way in which the masses congregated has changed, as well as our way of receiving and distributing information. Even the very idea of democracy, populism, and politics has changed. Change has already happened, and the power of that change has already appeared. But are we ready for it? This year is the 100 years anniversary of This year is 100 years anniversary of October Revolution. Next year is 50 years of Maystone, and the next 2019. Wow, so many anniversaries for so many big things. The anniversaries should not just be a memorial celebrating for the big event before 100 years. They imply an opportunity to revisit the historical potentials of the events is themselves also potential space for the history. Revisit the power of the nameless multitude, which is the power of the unrecognized and unrealized historical subject. To understand this power, we must strive to connect, follow, and respond to from the October Revolution to 1989, from the Cultural Revolution to the Color Revolution, from 1968 to the present, all throughout the progress in biohistory, social history, political history, intellectual history, and of course, technology history. In order to write up a supplementary manifesto for the complex, contradicting, and unpredictable 20th century. Yes, let's write up a supplementary manifesto for the 20th century. In my mind, the first sentence of the manifesto should be this sentence: what it produced above all are its own grave diggers, by Karl Marx. And as I just said, after the revolution, evolution of the 20th century, capitalism has gone through multiple generations and presented an updated version, from exploitation to dispossession, from oppression to substitution, from occupation to domination. How can we create a potential space to overcome this new governance of message spectacle capital? As a curator and as a former dean of a new media art school, I propose the hacking of new media and new art. It should be continued. It's a call for a new media art of the future. One, new media art should not mean those works and products by new media artists, and can easily be placed in existing historical narrative, and thus can easily be assimilated by contemporary art institutes. New media art should not be placed in galleries and museums. Instead, it belongs in the hands and eyes of billions of ordinary citizens around the globe. It exists in the flow of signals, in the dissemination of information, and in the mind of billions of anonymous users. New media art is an event that is consistent with the narrative of art history, and its existence is based on sociality. The event of new media art occurs not because art as such has acquired or utilized the technology of new media, but because the radicality of the new technical medium and the medium and the everyday life has transcended artistic radicality itself. Or to put it alternatively, the resoil of art should from its previous predicament has unleashed. While the technical nascency of new medium, the creation of new media art and its eventual impulses. As such, new media art is forced into existence by conflicts. The media is a message, and only the most novel content, the most radical message can become the media. The mention of new media art is not to express oneself artistically while existing new media, but to create a new media through art. New media art has to make the media in our hand the most incisive and controversial content, thereby resisting against the new technologies of control and seduction. The predicament of new media is the predicament of our new politics. The digitalization that has driven the development of new media is an ever more pervasive, ubiquitous and rigid form of grammatization and conversation, which is also the further imprisonment of humankind by the new technologies. The 21st century is a century of final confrontation between we mankind and our digital humanity, the essence of our digital being. Both the cure and the poison are in new media itself. In the age of new media, surveillance and discipline become more and more rigorous and precise. But this in turn also lay bare for us the means of governance employed by the despotic leaders of the world. New media art is a battlefield where the free union of multitude struggle with sovereign surveillance. Social media is nothing social at all. Not only is it not social, it is antisocial. It commercialized our personal concerns, co-presence, and interactions of the common. It is a form of self-spectacularization and consumerization of the effect of the common. The real sociality of media should be to thoroughly facilitate the interactions and the circulations of beliefs and effects among social members in order to forge the social sensibility or common consciousness required to initiate a new form of action, which incrementally can result in new social progress. In order to achieve this sociality, We must transform social media into a media of the society. For this, we must first make social media a new media for art. New media art must be open source, so it is transnational and trans-class. It should strive to repay the bank check that have been issued countless countless times in 20th century art history, which states that everyone can be an artist. The implication of this proposition is every viewer can be transformed into an artist, every reader can be transformed into a writer, every consumer can be transformed into a producer. Today, new media is in our hands. Through new media, everyone, and all of us can create art and enter into the artistic moment to create our own life. New media art is a self-empowerment of the spectator's artistic ability, which is also a social ability. For this, it must be an art for the people, an art for production, and an art for emancipation. The global military domination of the US by drones, warfare, and etc. in the price that we have already paid in the age of new media. We are always baffled that our enemies are always faster than us. When we are still marbling with social media, thinking that the future of democracy is based on that, our enemy has already acted. We should counteract faster. We must invent a new plan to fight against this making of new media into a totality system of surveillance and domination. For this, the most critical task for new media art is to enter the enemy's territory of technologies in order to fight our way back to the light. The mission of new media art is also to assemble a new collective action against the hypermass, against the herdification that deprive everyone of their statuses and essences. To act against the herdification, we need to assemble together as a group, just as a gang of wolves in the snow. New media art must drive people out from the bubble of social media, from the devoid public space that is easily compromised by our enemies. It must embrace more and more of the common in order to create a space for the common. The aim of new media art is to occupy the technology capital of new media, to invent a media weapon for the public, to destruct the aesthetic political spectacle devices that contemporary capitalism has constructed, to construct a site for mass connectivity and self-liberation. In order to achieve this, new media and art at their present form are far from sufficient. Therefore, we must resuscitate new media's function of social meditation. Meditization, in order to produce a form of new media art that is also a media of and for the society, and to develop a creativity that belongs to the common of the people. So, dear future new media artists, let us put aside our ever-changing form of vanity, put aside the illusion of success, put aside the burden of self-recognition through the art history of ourselves. Put aside the old venues of gallery, biennale, art fair, museum. Put aside the old prop of the so-called contemporary art. Let's dive into the battlefield of the ordinary life. Let's explore the new media art that is public and belongs to the everyday life of the people. In the spirit of equality, of creative passion, and of the willpower to struggle, let us use media and art action as a mean to resist deceitful compartmentalization of sensibility. The dispossession and substitution of spectacle capitalism, as well as the domination of by politics. Let us reconstruct our perceptive faculty, reinvent our language in order to create artistically a new media that points towards a future of equality for all forms of sensibilities. 20, the last one. Just as the future media art should be open sourced, the manifesto is also open sourced, which everyone has a right to define, use, alter, and revoke. Thank you.
So we have a few minutes for questions immediately to clarify things that we might want to have clarified before we move on to the next speaker. But there's also plenty of time for a broadened discussion at the end of this panel, when we will of course invite Irit Rogoff and also Johnson Chang for the panel discussion. But if there's any question that needs to be posed directly, please feel free to ask Gao Xiuming. And the same goes for comments that directly concern the talk, of course. And these are these painful moments of silence, but I will be patient for one more second.
Yeah, maybe later, together.
There is a question, actually. maybe somebody could get you a microphone.
Hello. Oh, so loud. Yes, it's not a question that I have. My name is Pia Schweikert. I am also, like everybody here, a manifestation of the evolutionary consciousness collective that we are all. And I want just to say how much I am happy about to meet here so many people and to hear a manifestation like this that will help in our future to build a better world if everybody starts to use the light inside and to take part against transmission of the virtual reality that shows things like all the games with war and children small that already go inside war with they walk like a soldier, they fight, they go with Pokemon, they shoot. And I am afraid that in future the human will go this way, and so I'm very happy to see here how the elite of art thinks same. That's all that I wanted to say.
Yes, this. Thank you for your comment, maybe more of a comment than a question, but if you want to respond, of course, Xiuming, you're most welcome.
Yeah, it's really... Wait, hello?
Hello.
Thank you for comments, I think. But I think the virtual reality is also reality, and the game is also life. Both of them are just our interface, or maybe a potential, of course, and tactical space for our self emancipation.
Okay.
If I may,
Sure, there's one question from, I think it's Siegfried Zielinski, actually.
the most complicated question, perhaps, and the most provocative right at the beginning, Ximing. You referred several times to the people. It's for us very difficult to understand what that is, the people, and what you mean with this subject when you say the people. You ended also your manifesto with these three terms, people, production, emancipation. I think the most difficult to understand for us is the first one, people. Perhaps you can comment just with a short answer how you understand it.
That's very important and very, it's really a complexity when we talk about who is the people. Actually, we have a long-term project to research that. We have a series of workshops on titled The Name of the People. Yeah, people, you know, we have a lot of names, a lot of titles for the people, from the cosmopolitan of Kant and to public, to the citizen, and to, of course, the mass, the mass, and also the people, by the initiated by the revolution. Yeah, it's very complex and a lot of contradiction in the in this field of the conception. Yeah, but the people in my people in my text, in my in this context is just to in it something like what we refer to with the so-called multitude, but maybe more historical dimension.
Yes, thank you, Gao Ximing. I think we'll stop here for the moment with this round of questions, okay. And we'll continue discussing with you in the panel discussion after the presentation, the lecture of Irit Rogoff. Okay. Thank you again, Gao Ximing. Okay. No. No.